Hey guys, welcome back to the second time lucky mining channel. In today's video, we are going to combine two of my favorite things at the moment. We're going to take this Octominer X8 Ultra and combine it with a couple of GPUs that I've managed to pick up on the secondhand market and create a Flux mining rig. If you do like this type of content, please smash the like button and maybe consider subscribing to the channel. It will help me out a great deal. But let's jump into the content. Now, if you are familiar with the channel, you would know I already have a Octominer X8 Ultra that I bought previously. And if you haven't watched that video, I'll leave a link in the video description and tag it at the top. But I was a super happy customer and hence I ordered another one. Yes, I am not sponsored by Octominer. This is a honest review of my experience buying it, getting it delivered and actually using it for the last couple of months. Now, this time around, I did do something slightly different. So within the X8 Ultra previously, and I'm not sure if this is still the case, but there used to be two different versions. There is a 1800 watt version, which is the one that I've bought, and this one here that I've bought this time around for 3000 watts. Both of them come with four server PSUs, just a wattage difference. So the older model, or the one that I bought previously, has four 450 watt PSUs, and this one has got four but 750 watts. So it gives me a little bit more breathing room. Regarding price, previously the other model that I bought, end to end, I paid about $850. That included a $300 shipping, so it was quite expensive to get it here in Australia. This time around, I paid $1,000, so it's about $150 more, but I get a lot more PSU space. And this time around, the shipping was actually a little bit cheaper, so I paid about $250 for the shipping. Now, what I want to do in this video is take all of the GPUs that I've currently got mining Flux in the garage and move that into the Octominer case and install a couple of new ones, so that at the end of the day, I've got two Octominer cases. The one is mining the crap out of Ethereum while the fun lasts, and the other one is mining Flux. And that's really the two things that I'm mining at the moment. Now, let me go and show you guys what the setup looks like today. So here we are in the garage, and as you can see, this is the open air frame that I want to go and move into the Octominer case. So currently there's five GPUs on this open air frame. On the left, this is the current Octominer that I've got, and currently it's mining Ethereum on two miners getting paid out in Bitcoin. And this is actually the Bitcoin that I mined from this device is what I've used to actually buy the Octominer. So the objective of today is take this open air frame and move it into the Octominer and add the extra GPU that I managed to scoop up on the secondhand market. So here we go. I've taken the open air frame out of the dark dingy dungeon in the garage and placed it on here. And what we're going to do now is we're going to move these GPUs ultimately into the Octominer there. Now, the first thing that I wanted to highlight is you absolutely don't need necessarily an Octominer. Yes, I want an Octominer, and there's various different reasons for that. You know, an open air frame, there's really nothing wrong. In fact, you know, if you look at the review that I've posted, you know, an open air frame typically would be quieter and potentially cost less compared to the Octominer. But, you know, some of the benefits that I do get with the Octominer is all of this cable junk. So you can probably see all of these cables and the second GPU and all of these type of things together with the fans of all the GPUs and my cooling fans here. You know, I've got two little kids running around. You've probably seen them on the background on the photos. You know, I don't want them pulling out wires or sticking their fingers in any of these fans. And that's what's actually quite nice about the Octominer. Number one, you are getting dedicated airflow, so it pushes a lot more air in a direction compared to what you get with an open air frame. So typically it would be cooler. And then, you know, it's a little bit safer for the kids because I only really have the power cables at the back of the Octominer and there's no fans that are exposed. So those are some of the benefits that I quite like of the Octominer. But the point being is there's nothing wrong with an open air frame. This is probably the cheapest and easiest and what I've been using for a very long time. It's just, I'm a little bit spoiled now with the Octominers. So, you know, that's just what I would want to use for me, at least for the future. Now that we've covered the basics, let's jump into the time lapse and actually do the build. Now, I've managed to take out all of the GPUs out of the open air mining frame, and let's have a quick look at the GPUs from small to big, from a hash rate perspective, and really from a flux hash rate perspective before I go and install them into the Octominer. Now, the first one being the 3060 Ti, so this is unfortunately a Galax model, so I would not touch a Galax model necessarily, but when I bought the actual open frame, and again, you know, I will not leave a link in the video description, nor will I tag it at the top, but that was my first video when I bought secondhand the open air frame that came with two GPUs, one being a 2070 and the other one this Galax card. So, you know, I bought it secondhand from a guy that didn't want to mine anymore. Now, the 3060 Ti, I think it's got Hynix memory, but it gets about 50 to 55 mega hashes or solutions on Flux. Now, the next GPU is a 3070. This is a EVGA XC3. Again, this is one that I bought secondhand, and it gets about, all the 3070s gets anything between 65 and 67 mega hashes, and probably at around 200 watts. So I've got another one. I've got a Asus TUF one here. So you can see here is a Asus TUF model. This one I actually bought brand new when the GPU prices started to drop, but both of these 3070s are LHR, unfortunately. So obviously the one I got secondhand and this one I actually bought new, they get about probably 65 to 67 mega hashes, as I mentioned, and anything from 175 watts to about 200 watts. So this, unfortunately, EVGA one, to obtain the 65 sols, it needs a little bit more wattage, where the Asus one just uses 175 watts. So that's actually quite nice. I do really like the 3070s. I think overall from a GPU, they get probably the most consistent hashes to watch efficiency and heat perspective. I really don't like GDDR6X memory, and you probably have seen the theme. I don't have any 3080s, 3080 Ti's, 3070 Ti's, 3090s. I try and stay away from the GDDR6X memory. But anyway, now let's move on to the bigger ones and probably the ones that I'm the most excited. And you probably can see on the smile on my face, I really wanted these 2080 Ti specifically for Flux. So I managed to actually get, and this was last weekend, two Asus Strix models. So here is the other one here. As you can see, two of the same cards. I actually got it from a gamer. I had to drive very far to go and pick it up. I was super stoked. The person had them in their gaming PC in SLI, so I wasn't aware that SLI is still a thing, but anyway, I was super happy to pick up the two GPUs from this fine gentleman. And then my wife managed to pick up yesterday another 2080 Ti, so this one hasn't started mining. So these cards I want to move as quickly as possible into my Octominer and get them hashing and show you guys what it looks like in HiveOS. So let's go and install them into the Octominer. Okay, so this is what it looks like once it's filled with GPUs. So I've got the three 2080 Ti's here on the left, and as you can see, I've got one spot here on the left open. This is where the CPU and motherboard is, and I've got another spot open right there. And then I've got there the two 3070s and the 3060 Ti. I just need to do a last little bit of cable management there and then close it up and have a look in HiveOS. Okay, I managed to install the GPUs, done my cable management. I even installed the little fancy handle here, but I realized that I completely forgot to tell you what you actually need to get started. Now, what I like to do, as I mentioned, you really just need the GPUs and potentially a power cable, but let's quickly talk about the other things that comes with it. Now, you would have noticed, and again, if you watched my previous video on the review, it comes with an SSD. On this SSD, HiveOS is already installed, but what you can do is what I normally do is use a device like this to connect the SSD to USB to my computer, and then I move my rig.config file onto the Octominer SSD. So that saves me from plugging in a monitor or anything like that. The other little nuance that I do is, you know, the Octominer comes with a connector like this, or a splitter, or I don't know what you call this, but it comes with the normal PSU cables at the back that you would normally find on any ITX and potentially some of these other server cases, but it's got this special connector here. Now, my PDU doesn't support this, which is not a problem at the end of the day, because I can still stick these ones into my PDU, and that's typically what I do. By the way, I've recently joined the Sleep Money Club, started by your friend Andy and Colin the Decade Investor. It's really a Discord community of like-minded individuals helping each other to achieve their crypto and financial goals. I'm in there every day in the typical channels for mining, helium, flux, and so forth, helping people with their various different setups. In case you would like to join, I'll leave a link in the video description to that. But let's have a quick look at what this thing can do in HiveOS. All right, so here we are in HiveOS. So there's a couple of things that I did that potentially you should be doing as well. So I've just updated HiveOS just to make sure that the version is compatible. Obviously I've done a reboot, and then what I've done is apply my overclocks, because you know, it was all over the show. Some of the 3070 overclocks went to the 2080 Ti's and the 3060 Ti, same thing. So I quickly applied the overclocks onto the various different cards, and I'm now having a look and see. So here you can see the 20 Ti's, at least two of them are performing the way that I expect them to perform. So here you can see this specific one is about 97 megahash or sols, and then this one as well. But the new one that I've added, and I'm assuming this is the new one because the other ones didn't really have an issue, I can see is only hashing at 92. So something that I noted as soon as I started it up, and looking at the fan here, the fan is quite high. So I think there might be something around the cooling on this new 2080 Ti that I've got. So I probably need to go and have a look at that. So I'm gonna open up the Octominer again and just have a look at this new card that I added. I probably should have looked at it individually before, but anyway, I have to look at it now. But yeah, that's how easy it is to move your GPUs into an Octominer and actually get them hashing. So you can see currently I'm hashing at about 440 sols on this specific rig. Quick little insert, I managed to open up the new 2080 Ti that I got secondhand and repaste and a good clean sorted it out. So here you can see I'm getting about 98 mega hash on both or all three 2080 Ti's. That's it for this one, guys. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video. If you did, please smash the like button and consider subscribing to the channel. If you didn't, please specify in the comments what you would like me to change. Otherwise, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.